Welcome to part 3 of the 3 videos covering the topic how to draw the common external tangent to two circles of different diameters. We hope to become your favorite AutoCAD resource online, and we thank you for joining us. We'll be starting the video on instruments. This would be your the grade 4 pencil that you'll be using. We're going to turn off snap. I'm going to select single line text right here. The height would be 4. The angle would be about 190. All right, so let's label this now tangent. Are we going to rotate it so that it is inline? So we're going to go rotate. Enter. Gonna choose here as the base point, and we're just gonna rotate it just like that. Are we gonna label the normal now? So I guess I have to extend the normal here. Now I'm gonna put it here. I'm gonna move this 50. I move it down here. Alright, so I'm gonna label normal here. And I'm gonna put the normal out here. Alright, so we're gonna go single line text right here. The height would be 4, rotational angle 0. Height would be 4. The angle looks like about 80 degrees. Enter. So we're going to label this normal. All right, we need to rotate the, okay, there it is, good. We're going to label right here to normal. So we're gonna go single line text, select right here. There's no space to put it on the inside. 979 degrees. All right, so this is normal. All right, we're gonna rotate it, right? So we're gonna, all right, so there it is. So this would have been our completed drawing for today's lesson. Let us label. We're gonna go multi-line text, and we're gonna label right here. Gonna choose there. All right, so the height will be 4 millimeters. Okay, all right, so it's to construct a common external tangent to two circles of different diameters. Alright, to complete our drawing, what we're going to do, we're going to put the center lines for the two circles. So we already have this center line, we're going to put the perpendicular center line. So we're going to change to our center line layer. We're going to go to line, we're going to turn on object snap, and from here we're going to draw a line. We're going to turn on ortho to make sure the line is vertical. So we're going to go there, enter, enter to get the last command. Here, there, enter. All right, we need to turn off object snap. So we're going to go line, intersection. I'm going to turn off object snap, and we're going to go vertically there. Enter, enter to get the last command. I'm gonna turn on object snap. There, coming down, I'm gonna turn off object snap. There, enter. So this completes our Drawing. What we can do, we can join the, we're going to turn off the dimensions. No, we didn't. Or what we're going to do, we're going to make a dimension layer, a dim layer. I call it dim, short for dimension. So we're going to new, dim, mention layer. I'm going to make it current by clicking it here. I'm going to close the layer properties manager. And I'm going to put this measurement on the dimension layer. Then I'm going to turn it, I'm going to lock it. I'm going to turn it off. Press OK. OK, what I'm going to do, I'm going to make the center lines 1. So I'm going to go to the modify ribbon. I'm going to go to the join. I click on it. I'm also going to join this one. So I'm going to come on the modify ribbon. I'm going to click this icon that says join. And when I click on it now, it will be one line. See? And what we're going to do, we're going to make our center line layer over the circle at B. So we're going to go line from the center. We're going to turn on object snap from this intersection. I'm going to turn on or authorize on. I'm going to click here. Enter. Enter to get the last command. I'm going to draw the line above also. Enter. And this would be our center line. We're going to go, we're going to click join, the join command. And we're going to join these two lines. Enter to make them one. So when you click on it now, see it's one. All right. So we're going to turn on the dimension layer so we can see the 150 millimeters that we All right, so if we move up, this is our completed drawing. All right, here we have our tangent. What we're gonna do, we're gonna fix the drawing. So we're going to click on this radius 22 and we're gonna bring it around. All right, right there. Good. Now the next thing we're gonna do, we're going to break the normal, the tangent. It's too long. So we're going to go to the modify ribbon. We're going to go to break. We're going to select the tangent. Press. And then we're going to select the break point. We're going to turn off snap. And I'm going to select the break point right here. All right, enter. So when I click on it now, see, that's a line by itself, so I can delete it. Good. All right, the other part I'm going to break is the arc. All right, so we're going to go to break. This arc is too tall, right? So I'm going to click on it. That's the object. Then I'm going to click right there. Good. So enter to get the last command. I click on the object. And the breakpoint, I'm going to choose right there. Enter. All right, so when I click on this, see, that's a different arc, so I can delete it, right? Or we can break this line, right? So we're going to go to break this arc. I'm going to click on this, and then I'm going to choose right there. Enter. Alright, so when I select this arc, no, that part is one, it's a different part because I broke it, right? So I can delete it, right? So this brings us to the end of today's video. In today's video, we looked at how do we construct an external tangent to two circles of different radii. In the next video, we'll be looking at how do we construct an internal tangent to two circles of different radii. We look forward to seeing you in that video. Please take care until we meet again, and thanks for joining us in today's video. Bye. We have come to the end of part 3 of the 3 videos covering the topic, how to construct the common external tangent to two circles of different diameters. We thank you for joining us, and in the next video, we'll be drawing the common internal tangent to two circles of different diameters. We look forward to seeing you in that video, and please take care until we meet again. Bye.
Thanks for watching the video, and don't forget to subscribe, hit the notification bell, like, comment, and share.